It is like Oyama's 87 bulls he killed. He never did. It's the same with the sharpshooters in the Old West. I read from a newspaper in those days that two famous fighters, they were shooting at each other and it took them 5-6 times before they finally hit each other. So it's all bullshit. It's like not every technique works on everybody. Absolutely not.
It's fine.
But don't try to reach when you feel uncomfortable.
Hello. Hi, can I give you a phone back? I have John Blooming over.
Don't do it. Tokyo Iwano said, you should see.
I'll speak to you soon, okay? Take care, bye.
Martial arts, so not martial fighting, but martial arts, like a big plate of fruit. You have apricots on there, bananas, cherries, apples, oranges. Now, Peter is allergic for oranges, so he won't take that. Somebody else for bananas. Other guys here, they don't like bananas, so they take the apricots. Take whatever is healthy for you. It's the same with techniques. If you feel comfortable with some technique, and even your teacher said, well, you shouldn't do that, it's very difficult, then he is the wrong teacher. Because anything you do, and it works on several championships, it works in the dojo, then it is good. Even if I look at it, Jesus Christ, how does he do that? That shouldn't work, but it works for him. Take it. I remember when I started judo, I didn't know that judo was done usually in those old days to the right side throwing. Because I don't know how come, but as soon as I started judo, I grip like this. So it was for me natural that I throw on this side. So after a few weeks, when I started succeeding in doing a hip throw at higher belts, Opa Schutter said, Johnny, are you a lefty? I said, what do you mean? I said, do you left-sided reader? I said, no. He said, that's funny. This is the first time I see that ordinary guy for the right side doing left side throws. He said, but keep it up, because not many guys have a good defense to the left side. And that's what was very good also in Japan, because I killed them with my left side. Do whatever you feel comfortable with. Take those things. Hirano always said, if you have one throw, and even if you throw everybody with it, after 6 months, you throw almost nobody with it anymore. Because they got used to it, they know. So Hirano had his Tai Toshi. That hurt me more than Hirano. His Tai Toshi turned, oh, boom, he was beautiful with it, with his face almost to the ground. Boom, he threw them all. But after that, they jumped over it, or resist, or things like that. So then he come in, and instead of going here, he goes here. And then he goes, Ochigai, there. Then he goes, Kochigai, there. So he had seven words, which was the seven throws. It was the Hirano Kata. And when I showed it in Japan, they looked at me. I said, yes, Tokyo Hirano. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. But he had his own kata. That's the same. If you have one punch, people will defend. I don't know how, but they will. But if you have two punches, and then the low kick, and then shift another low kick, get him, boom, get him down. Then one of the other, you build up your technique, you build up your fighting ability. And that's the only way to get somewhere. And if you want to be in the K1 or good kickboxing, then you should have a kind of masochistic pain leverage. Put it on a lower ground, lower, lower, until, as a matter of fact, you almost like pain. Otherwise, you will never be a champion. I see many a times this. but they're here, and now they get punched. How? This is the mixed martial arts. See? As soon as you're in this position, put two hands up. See? Now, if he is in between, there's nothing he can do, so he has to get outside. Up, and then he starts punching. Up. Take hands, put your leg up, so he can't hit you with this. See? Foot. Hold this. Now turn on your side. Up. Hold it. Hold him here. Push the leg away. Up. You can go two ways. You can go this way, or you can go this way. Up again. Up. There you are. Even if it takes a while, you got him locked in, so it's not that he can fight you to his advantage. He can only fight trying to have a delay of his execution. See? In a real fight, you hit him, pow. It's a lot because it's mixed martial arts. See? So I see people, well, he's going, pow. And he sees the light or the stars. See? And then you can hit him. So, again, important is this. Hold him. A lot of people pull him down. It's good too, because now you got him boxed in and there's not much he can do. But there's not much you can do either. So why should you do it? Let him go. Try to make mistakes. Maybe you get one punch or two, you know, with the glove, which is not that bad. See? Hold up, get the arm with two hands. You can put your leg over it. That's the Jean LaBelle style. See? Or hold him here and get the leg away so that he falls on his face. Or here, pop, hold him, get him here. And get him down. Up. Both sides, you have to be very supple in the legs and in the body movements. See? From here, you shift on one thing. Once you've got him here, shift. Have this here. Down. But. Up.
Cut the shoulder.
And have this here. Not here. And not make the arm lock with the hands. Make the arm locks with your thigh. But not wrong. He can hold it a long time. I could. They never got me in that. Never. Not even in Japan. Because once you make this arm lock on me. One. See, when you're here, now twist your hips and twist your elbow. And just, even if it is 1 centimeter, pull it down. When you're here, overstretched, you're finished. When you're here, turn and put your elbow in his thigh or in his balls. See? Foot. That's it. One. Keith, hop, get him, get him. Hop. Where's he? See? Trein. In the mat and hold him like you're having a wild horse. Wow. And then pretend that these are two sharp knives and cut his throat. Chat, 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 chat. If you feel better like this, or you feel better like this. I can't do it like this anymore with the shoulder, but pat, 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 pat. That's it. I showed you yesterday when he is rolling over and you're too late, he gets up, just whack it around. You know, like you have a whip, swap. And don't go like this. Don't go like that. Go straight. Straight up. Punk. Here. Punk. Punk. What used to work, but with this outfit you guys have, that doesn't really work anymore. But I will try to show you anyway. When you're between his legs, and I always hate it, and I never recommend it, you should be over it or beside it, but not between his legs. But once you are between his legs, I love it when he has got a gi on. Yes. Because now I just go down here and grip the gi, huh? And go. And hold them, hold them, hold them. Hey, the tighter. Lovely, lovely. Now you choke them like this. In the old days I used to padam and turn off. And it is like the old Spanish, what's the name again? Like they have in the old days, you know.
Spanish Inquisition.
Right. Fall off. If he has a gi, grip like this. But not close to his throat. About this much down. Go in and uppercut him, but on the crotus. Down. Fap. Fall off. Go. He kills himself. You can't ask Kaminaka anymore because he died. But when he was champion in 1960, in May 1960, during the Olympic training, he came in. Everybody wanted to fight with him, it was a whole line waiting. But I was the best foreigner in those days, and third in the Kenshu side, the 25 best fighters of Japan. So I came in and passed the line and said, Onikashimasu. And he smiled because it's the first time we were fighting each other. He was 102 kilos, I was 102 kilos. He had a very fast Taitoshi. So we fought, he came in twice, dropped me on one knee, which would have been a coca, or I don't know, the stupid little things they have in judo now. I tried twice my hip throw and jumped in those knees. The next time I came in, he stumbled, I had him on the ground. He has his knees around me, boom, I came in, fall off, and boom, twisted, and then I felt, oh boy, he's gone, but I couldn't get my hands out. So old man Sato came running, ripped the arms apart, and there was Kaminaka. So outside on a stretcher, he was laying there for 20 minutes. And they said, Jesus Christ, now I know why he's got the name Horanda no Dobutsu, or a beast from Holland. He was out. The beast from Holland, it's also a very funny story. I tried to fight with somebody 17 years old, like a sumo tori. He was not that big, a little smaller than I was, but 150 kilo belly and ass and blubber tits. So we fought and fought, but there's nothing much he could do. He tried a little leg throws, was nothing. Finally I came in, I couldn't throw. Then I came in and I could do a squat easily with 180 kilo. When he is 150 kilo, when I come in with my hip and make contact and not go through, then I can lift him, which I did. So I lifted him and then I threw him. And his feet went over the ground like, cow up. Beautiful if you see 150 kilo fat moves. So he stood up at that time. Now I'm gonna throw him with my, also the guy for which I was very well known. So I came in, I was too fast. I came in and my toe was under my foot. And my leg already behind this fat son of a bitch. And he just set his ass down. So all you hear is, oh Jesus, from my ass to my hair I felt it. So I went up and the toe was dead. So I stumbled away. Next day, Draco looks, I had a foot this big, like in Ermelo when I threw these 75 guys. And he said, oh, that looks good, nice colors. You know, red, dark blue, yellow, this big. So all the brittle bone around the big toe was completely destroyed. So he said, John, you can do two things. You can let it heal, takes you 6 weeks, 2 months. Said, or you have this Marine special. He used to be a Marine colonel, fought in Guadalcanal, had the Silver Star, was wounded there by a sniper, made lieutenant. I said, well, let's hear it, because he was also a practical joker and, you know, always joking around. I said, let's hear it. He said, well, you just pick up the toe, take a deep breath, and go, I said, what? I said, you're kidding me. He said, no, because you will deaden the nerves. It won't hurt anymore. He said, and it heals faster because everything is loose again. He said, oh boy. I said, well, if I'm going to do that, I want to show the nips that we can be tough too. We do it upstairs. So Bill and Drake both went upstairs. I was going in the dojo. Sit down. Everybody was looking. Oh, good, good, good. He can't fight for sure today. So I was sitting there and look. So I pick up my toe and I'm looking. And all you hear was, and sure as hell, the pain was gone. And Bill later said, he said, you know what was very funny? He said, your head was more purple than your toe. I said, Bill, you won't understand what a terrible pain that was, but only for a few seconds. The problem. So I stood up, everybody, so then I pick out, but that didn't work so well. But from that day on, they called me Horanda Nadobutsu, the beast from Amsterdam. I thought it was a 100 titles, so I liked it. You guys wanted to do very soon the Shotai Kumites. This is fighting, not with the fist, but with the open hand. I developed this open hand after I had a fight with Five Pins in Amsterdam in autumn 63. And I nearly killed the guy. And so I thought, I'm not gonna use my fist anymore in a fight on the streets. So I really developed a good Shotai. And believe you me, if you know the Shotai and know how to apply it, then it is just a good knockout, like you hit him with your fist. With only this good point, you don't see so much from the outside, like you whack him with your fist and a big black eye, broken nose, I don't know what. You whack him with your hand, it's only a kind of red, but inside he completely hears the telephone every few minutes, for at least a month. And he is not the same guy anymore, if you hit him correctly. You need somebody. You must remember that one. See? Here. You have a few types. Two of the most important ones is the one straight. So, everybody can see it. So, straight, like you're a sniper. You put your rifle in the direction of your victim and squeeze the trigger and the bullet comes out. Not like this. Turn like a bullet. Get your fingers a little bit up. Not too much. Don't overdo it. Have your monkey hands. You can do it not touching at all. Skin touch. Light touch. And hit them a little bit and knock them out. Always this.
I missed that one. Can I? Can
I see Don't make a mistake of having your thumb outside, because then you get just a lovely thumb as I could. Don't hit it in two places. Not with short tie, but trying to hit somebody in the stomach and his elbow was in the way, so I hit the elbow right here. Oh. And that hurts. So, that's the straight one. So anywhere, you know, when he tries to hit you, but, and of course he will come with the second one. Hit that down. Come on, everything. Get! Make yourself empty. Second one is actually like a mawashigiri. Mawashigiri with the palm of your hand. Mawashigiri comes from the knee. Here it comes from the elbow. It breaks at the elbow. And the underarm makes the attack. When I am challenged on the street, sometimes it happens in Amsterdam, or they were drunk, or they just generally didn't recognize me. Later years, they all recognized me and I never had any trouble. But I always fight like this, Kurostaki style. Yeah. So I don't look aggressive. I just look like a big dog, you know, like this. And as soon as he makes movement, I will tell him, good job, you are. Because he doesn't see it. My arm is here. So if I'm here, he knows something is going to happen. But if he sees this, he doesn't know. But what I really like is this one. And I knocked a lot of guys out with this. You know, just teaching him a lesson. Turn, you know, from here, turn and here. You kill the guy. It is like you bam, you know? Because this is rough too. This is bone crushing. But this makes your brain shake. Turn. Not here. Here. Bam. This you get that on your head, and you need, in the next 2 months, learn a new to talk again. Then I had another one, but that was just for fun, for my students. They would stand like this, and I would wait for them. I step on their foot. Oh shit, I can't move into it. I never see anybody do it, not in a fight, it's very funny. You know, once you're here, step on his foot, turn around, and walk. And you hear oops! And that's very funny. When you're in a fight, step on his foot. Now what he's going to do. For the last one for today, I show you. In the old days, I could never get my gi over my bicep. In our days, it's very easy. It's about, I would say, 20 centimeters less than in the old days. Here, envy. Now, envy you can do on two ways. One way is have your hand on your chest. So don't do it from here. You will miss 40-50% of the real attack. Have your hand on your chest. Here. That's the other one, that's defense. Turn from your hip. Turn from your hip and let your elbow whip out like a cobra striking. So it's not you know, like pushing him. No, it's like hitting him. Now this is the easy way. I hit him with the meaty part of my arm. And now I want to hurt them. Change your hand. Instead of having the hand with the palm against your chest, change it. Put your thumb against your chest. Now the little knockout bone comes free. Do exactly the same movement. But instead of hitting him with the meaty part, you hit him with the bony elbow. Pow! And that penetrates and you really give him a skull break if you hit him like this. See? That's very, very dangerous. That's why the K1 cut it out of the championships. Because the Japanese didn't like it. Because, of course, the Dutch were again better than they were. Pow! They broke a few jars and they stopped it. So, turn, warm up. But again, like the low kicks, warm up. From nothing, warm up. From nothing. Don't stop like this, then you know, oh boy. No, oh. See? And then, bam, and then smack, smack. Here you can hear the difference. Flat, flat, or pop, pop. Try it. But you should do it fast. Especially getting over it here. And flat. Get, see. Almost break his head here. Flat. Then take this. Or put your leg in, pop, 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 and then go down. Once again, not all those things work on everybody. Thank you. Say again. I was never one who did the haymakers. I don't know why, but I just never did, like, I never was really involved in leg locks. most probably because it all started when Kees Dolman in the early 70s won his first world title Sambo. He was more surprised than I was, because he thought there would be not only strong, but the techniques of Sambo were so poor that there was nothing against it. Sure it was, because Chris was a fighter in mind. He had a dictionary, but losing was not in there. So he always fought for everything. And he won in the finals from the 180 kilo former champion. It's unbelievable. He won twice after that, so he had three world titles there. And he showed the first techniques of that. I always thought if I can get close enough, or I can combine a defense attack, then the direct way from A to B is a straight line and not a turn. If I do a Seiken, that is faster than if I do a haymaker. It takes at least a quart or a half second longer. If you have a real experienced guy who doesn't make many or not at all mistakes, then it's difficult to knock him out. But this is faster. Once I'm in, I'm close and just whack it in and see that you hit with the index finger. And close, not here, close. The defense, when a fist comes, turn. Make a beer pad of your hand, see, like a waiter. That's all. So not, no. And if I can do it with my left shoulder, then you can do it easy. Don't go outside the line of your defense, the line of his defense or his attack. It's always in a triangle. Here is his face. Here he wants to hit you. Here are the hips, here he wants to hit you. She always comes in a kind of triangle. So always defend from ear to ear, not outside that, and certainly not outside the shoulders. If he comes with a punch, fuck. If you're in the shoulder still, then you're still a little open. So I always, you know, had my arm in front, or just bam, like the mitrailleur. Bam, bam. Soon as you have the trigger, one sets off the other bullet. Bam, bam. Bam, bam. So it's not bam. No, it doesn't work. It's not like the Chinese do. That Wing Chun business. They come out and with the same hand, they try to attack you. But the attack is weak, because they attack with fingers, boom, 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 boom. It makes you mad, but it's nothing to worry about. They also hit with this, with the little finger, which I think is very stupid, because if they meet your face and they meet the strong end of it, they break their little pinky, like the boxers do when they hit. They claim no, but I wonder why the Chinese are not in the K1, because they will never make it, is this. So, one straight line, Fawam will do it. But again, if you have a lot of success, Fawam, boom, may you knock him out. Well, be my guest. The more you knock out, the better it is for the IBK and for yourself, especially for yourself. So that's the difference. Low kicks, always when this is the opponent, don't hit like this. Hit like this. Hit like this. And hit here or here. This is the old war wounds. And I hit something again, so It's always funny, the colors it shows you. Another thing is like this, and then you see, the tendons. They are strong. Those tendons, if you make a pat, go right behind the knee, crack, and put this strong tendon right behind the knee tendons here like that. So, pop, you screw them up bad. Once you hit on the thigh, on the muscles, don't start ping-pong, because you hurt the guy, but not like he is going to drop. Because every time it's a new spot. But you hit him on the thigh, pow, oof! And you see already, that was a good one. Bang again, right on the same spot. No matter what you do, make combinations, but keep your head empty, but on the spot. Give everything. And you will see after 4 or 5, especially the 6th time, if the endurance of pain is very low, he can take it. Might be 8 or 10 times, but all of a sudden you see. He wants to get the leg out of the way, you hit it again and he drops. And it is possible to break it. Was Rutten, a good fighter, but so the trouble is that he is a psychopath for cocaine. But he broke a tie. Unbelievable. When I was coaching him, he broke the tie. So I told him to go to the hospital. So, half, like mea culpa. That was not what I meant. He said, yeah, but it was what I like to kill the son of a bitch. Said, oh shit, he's on the coke again. But he went there and he was friendly. He would drink me some newspaper. Man, did Bas Rutten, he is a real gentleman. Sure he is. But that are the things. Another thing is when they attack you with low kicks. If you can take it, that you trained it. Yeah? So the bone here, like I trained my wrist, then you can defend like bone on bone. Pop. You can take it. If not, then you should not turn your foot outside and defend like this. But you should defend like this. Then he hits you here. And you get the sting out of it. Of course, you will be hurt, but it will not knock you out that you can't stand on it anymore. No, so you should train that. You know, like, if you can take it like this, and jet, or as soon as he comes in, so jump. Don't go away. Like the turn around. Wow. You know that he is going to hit you with the back leg. Never with the front leg. It's impossible. So, if he is standing with left in front, you know he's going to attack with right. And I'm talking about the Taekwondo guys and those who are training it. It's a technique which very, very seldom works. And if it works, that is because the guy, instead of jumping in, goes a little back. Yeah? Like, you get the punch, he goes like this. You do that with a roundhouse kick from the back, you're screwed. Because he will hit you. I one time made a mistake with a big organization in Holland, or in Europe, I forgot what it is. And it was a good organization, and they do all kinds of martial arts. It's also kind of good, okay? And they invited me. And they were very nice. And there were lots of people all from Europe, and when I came in, they all stood up and, it was nice. So then I got very brave and I said, who knows a real good backwards roundhouse kick? Here comes a guy, he was not as big as I was, a little smaller, but at least 120 kilo was kind of belly. So I figured, cannot be that good. But he was terrible good. So I waited for him and he turned around, I jumped in and he still caught me for 20%, boom. And I said, that man is good, that's what the roundhouse kick meant. So I got away again, and won't make that mistake again. So I came again, and he came faster this time, and bang, I went in, boom, close. You know, and just whacked him between the legs. So he stumbled away. The third time he didn't want to do it anymore. But he nearly knocked me out. So never underestimate your opponent. Because you never know what you've got in front of you. Always watch it, and wait what's going to happen. Don't start like, oh, wait for him. No monkey hands. Bam. Any questions? Nothing. Mm-hmm. Well, you know
that they're all so good.
Udo people share everything among each other. So if your girlfriends are free this afternoon, I hope to see you guys again. Yes. In 66 it petered out. But I did teach it in my dojo that anybody who was doing karate also should know a few throws, at least three, and arm bars and chokes. We didn't have leg locks until Tis Dolman became the first world champion sambo super heavyweight and beat all the Russians. In the finals he beat 180 kilo former champion. Unbelievable, he is so strong. And then we found out about the leg locks and all that. I never was a real buff in leg locks because I didn't care so much. But I always had the Jean LaBelle ID. You don't like them, choke them out. In 1980, when I was really disgusted with all the martial arts assholes around me, and especially in Europe and the States, I quit in 79. And in 1980, I was invited again by the Navy, which I was teaching since 1964, and the Marines, please come and give us another seminar. So I went there, and I got the spirit again in the fire, and I told the one who was there, Jan de Bruin, who is now an eighth dan, he was then a second dan, and I told Jan, I said, look, you're going to make now the Kyokushin Budokai. Kyokushin, because what I learned from Oyama and especially Kurosaki, and Budokai for Trevor P. Leggett, who made the Budokai in London. And he said, I'm tired, and I'm talking about 1946 or 47, he said, I'm tired about all this politics and all this bullshit around judo. I'm going to open my dojo and call it the Budokai. Anybody can be there. He can teach if he wants to and just enjoy themselves with judo. But in the dojo, no talk about politics, no talk about religion, no talk about racism. Anybody who goes over that line will be out and never be back in. And I got that idea, I heard that from my own teacher, Opa Schutte. We called him Opa because he was, in our opinion, already old. He was 47. And he said, that's the idea of Leggett. I said, that's beautiful. So in 1980, I told Jan, I said, look, that's the spirit. Leggett was the first sixth dan in the world, together with O'Neill, before the war. And he is now an eighth dan from Japan. I'm not sure if it's from Japan, because those conceited bastards never gave anybody more than a sixth dan. Like Anto Giesing, when he became world champion, they had to, because he beat the hell out of everybody. Yeah. And I don't think there is anybody else who got a sixth dan from them, besides O'Neill and the American and Trevor P. Leggett. So that's how the Budokai started. The all-around system. It's the full circle, what the Japanese always like to say, oh, it's the full circle. They never had the full circle, that's why they get their ass beaten every day from the Europeans. But I said the first one-third is karate, kickboxing, Thai boxing, anything. When you have contact, which I hated in the old days, as soon as you had contact, and I was already a fourth dan and a fifth dan later at judo, I would throw him. None of the old schoolers in the Honbu of karate, they dared coming close to me because they knew as soon as they were, they don't kill you, I would have him, and they would go. So, when contact, throws. Hip throw, hip leg throw, backwards leg throw, and Ippon Seyanaka, which is very easy to do on karate people or kickbox people, and the sweep. You can sweep two ways. I never sweep like this because it hurts me. I always sweat like this, like the low kick. That you must know. That's the second part of the full circle. The third part is once throwing, whop, jump him, and do whatever you want on the ground. There are only two arm bars on the ground, the long one and the bent one. There are only two chokes. The one with the gi and the hadaka, so without the gi. There are two leg locks, straight and bent. But there are a thousand different ways of applying them and doing them from different positions. And a lot of people in the world, like Gogor and Jean LaBelle, had their system and they were really thinking and had their way, like somebody who can look in the future, you know, they're boom, they have this kind of brain, whenever you move, boom, and they do things which are completely basic, like you look at it and say, I'll be dead. Why didn't I see that? But that's the way they do. Like a girlfriend of my mother's in the old days, I came in a chocolate shop and she looked at me and she said, you back from the Marines, yeah? She said, but you're going to a war. Yeah, in a country we don't even know the name. There yeah, you'll be wounded, but you come back. I said, yeah, one is crazy. But it happened, I went to Korea. When I came back, I went again to the shop. Now I was a believer. And I said, auntie, what's gonna happen? I said, one thing is for sure, never Korea. Oh, no. And she looked at me and she said, you're going to Korea again. And I see wood around you. Yeah, there were the bunkers and the trenches. She said, and you're wounded again. But you do come back. Oh, shit. And sure as hell. I went back, not because I wanted to fight, but there was a ceasefire. And they were talking about the peace process. And we would be occupation troops. Of course, then I go back. Well, make a long story short, I was in the Suez Canal. Hear this. Peace progress is finished, broken off. They're back at the trenches. They're fighting like hell each other again. Oh, shit. As sure as hell, 11 October 1952, I was back in hospital again with a big piece of scrapnel behind my knee, which is still in there. So, this kind of foyer, I think they call it, where you can look in the future, that is for special people. And Jean LaBelle is one of those special people. He can do this on the ground. It's very funny. He beat Steven Seagal after he challenged him, and he jumped him during a movie thing. He was challenging him, oh, you have been, and what do you think you're going to do? Because you're walking behind me, you think you can? He said, yes. He said, well, do that then. A lot of witnesses. So, pardon, he was in his back, he strangled him. And Stephen didn't go to the toilet before he went to the movies. And he shed his pants and he pissed his pants in front of all the cameras. That made a lot of people happy because they didn't like him. Of course, Gene was fired, and Stephen said, I'm going to sue you, it's going to cost you millions. Of course not, with all those guys there who were witnesses, that he challenged them, asked them to do it, and that was the end. But that shows you. Steve, Gene was in those days, I think, 72 or 73, he is 79 now. And he is a terrific fighter. He broken all things in his body because he was 2 or 3 years in a row the best stuntman in Hollywood. Motorcycles, cars, but especially motorcycles and self-defense. So, if you have that kind of thinking on the ground, I had that maybe half or 30% of what Gene does. You can feel on the ground with your balance the mistakes the guy is going to make or is making at that moment and take advantage of that. And then you will find out that the game on the ground is especially a great pleasure if you can shift your weight, if you can prevent the guy to get up or to do something, just really dominate him until you just see in his face that he breaks mentally apart. Like I screwed up Willem Ruska, the famous European Dutch world champion and Olympic champion, 2 times Olympic champion. His Nawaza was lousy. I could hold him after I really screwed him up. Bam, 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 bam. One hand on his forehead and he couldn't get away. He was just mentally broken. Like you whip somebody, bam, 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 or an animal, bam, bam, and the animal is dead. You go, oh, he got enough. He is broken. And you can do that to a man. Just by laying on him when he wants to get up. That's tiresome. So he's like, oh, I escaped. And you turn, boom, and you're laying there again on his other side. Shit, he tries there again. You turn, boom, and you're laying there again. So the guy is like, he is in a little cage. The door opens a little bit, but he can't get out. He can't get out, he can't get out. He's going crazy. And you will see that in your career, if you keep going on with martial arts and Nawaza, you will see that you can break a guy mentally. Especially when he is a champion, or thinks he is a champion, and you break him because he finds out he is not that very good champion anymore. And that's what makes it very interesting. I'll show you again what my idea was from groundwork and turning around. That this is not judo. This is karate. Karate, kara means empty, te means hand. Empty hand. Flowery way of saying self-defense without weapons. So if I doing this game, the all-round game, then it is still karate, but all-round karate. Not judo. Of course you will see judo movements, but it is not in this content judo. One. When you see judo championships, you see this case of katame, and you see that they grip on the gi here and hold them. That's stupid. Because when I have my power here, he can get his arm out. Fop. And then I have to start all over. No, you have here a hole. See? You have here, above your hip bone, and the ribs. You have a hole. Put those two holes together and close the gap. Well, not here. Here you're strong. See? Now he's got to fight to get his arm out. Now just keep going. As soon as he gets out, because he will get out, especially when he's physically very strong, when he gets the arm out, turn. Turn, hop. And here you have what I call the fort. From here, inside the fort, you have the loopholes and you can snipe at him. Arm locks, holding, different types, and chokes. One. We get to that later. Here, when he is fighting to get out, you turn and lay down. And lay on his face. Hold the arm. Grip. And lay on his face. Because if you lay on his face, you will immobilize at least 50-60% of the power in his body. Because he can't move anymore. And only moving with his legs, that doesn't help very much. One. From here on, when he almost gets out, turn, keep low, keep laying on him. And close your knees behind his shoulders and your elbows on his biceps. Don't grip. Always have open hands. If he comes up, you know, to escape, just put your both open hands around his body and keep the pressure, especially on the biceps, and keep your belly on his face. Now we will shift to one side or the other, trying to get out. So he goes that way, then just here, you go that way, just lean on this one and keep the pressure on that one. See? The farther he goes away, the more pressure you keep here, because that will screw him up. He can't get out. When he is almost out, turn and put your knee behind his head. Pa-pam. Turn and lay down. And lay rough on his face. He wants to fight? Good. You want to fight too. Bam! Lay on his face. Hold him here. This is very difficult to get out of. Because I really blocked the head here. And I am 100 kilos. So I put most of it right on his face here. See? So if he starts to move, the only thing he can move is his underbody. But I control that easily. Not, no, I control it. You know, make my mind empty, like Zen. Lay there and wait for him. Of course he gets tired of that, so do I. So, pop. Always control. Always control. You know, so that he can't punk. Always control. 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 Go over it. Control. Control. Yes, sir. Like you're riding a horse. In this case, a Thai horse. One. If he has the arms of King Kong, or Chris Dolman, which is just the same, or Sergei Bardiuk, something like 50 centimeters. Here, one, he is so strong, you can't do this, then you go over it. And bang your whole crotch in him, prod, see? Crack, just twist it. Get up, take his head, turn and sit down here, crossed. See? If it is a street fight, grip the thing, break the finger so he can't grip you anymore, break his wrist, or in a sophisticated, nice fight among friends, here or here, or pick up the head and choke him. So again, one, arm goes out, get out, wrong, hold it. Not up, low, get the arm, scoop it up, 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 get the head away, and up. this leg here, and here, get the leg around it. Try that.
Just 3 minutes.
Fourth, this is important. I see many people who grip like this. No, it's wrong. You have 5 or 6 hands. This is one hand. That together, 3 hands, 4 hands, 5 hands, 6 hands, 7 hands. Always hands, always control. Don't grip like this. Grip with your other hand, here. Now you have your hand, your original hand. You are free to do whatever you want. You want to get them out, you want to screw them up. See? 1, 2. Here, your elbow on your knee. So now he can't get his arm out. See? Up, up, up. And I close. If I really want to make him happy, I put my shoulder, which is another hand, right on his head. Wow. See? Up. Don't worry about the noise you hear, it's just breaking up the shoulder again. See? Now he can't get away. This is very difficult because I control 60% of his body now. See? 1. From the fourth, you go up and you put your pinky right on his throat and go down and grip the shoulder and put your elbow down, which makes him very happy. See? Up, up, up. Not here. I see that many times. It's too much, and he can resist, see, and I cannot choke him, see. Oh, he's strong enough to hold it, but he's not strong enough when I put my knife in there. But, see, then I cut his throat. So. Second one, here, 1. I go back again. Get his head, put my leg around him, put my knee around his head, pop up, see. So I have completely boxed him in. And then I go back. See? Same type of arm lock. And you see there is not like you see in all those martial arts, mixed martial arts championships. The most of them, if you see them sitting in a restaurant, their eyes are somewhere 60 kilometers further, you know. Which means if you look in his right ear, you can look straight through it because there's nothing in there. And that's what they call a street brawl. It has nothing to do with martial arts. Hell no, it's not an art at all. It's just two stupid bastards who try to kill each other. So, 1. Take it. Fap. Fap. Put it up. Fap. Up. Up. This is the Jean LaBelle style and the Gogo style, with who is his best student. Jean is the only one we promoted last year to 10 dan for the first time in the 30 years history of the Budokaikan. And well deserved. He's 79 now and he is still a terrible guy to meet on the ground. 1. 2. Keep your knee on his hip. Keep this arm in, even if you control. If you have a wrestler, he will start bridging. Whap. See? If your arm is under it, then you can't choke him. But you can do, and just turn your hand up. Up. See? So he bridges again. I put it up. See, now the power is gone. See, here he can't bridge anymore. I got his head, and I got his arm, and I got his other arm, and I control his body. And that's what I call the Nervasa art, instead of here I can mentally destroy him, because everything he tries, he gets in an ambush or another trap again. And that really
getting you down. See? Another thing, here is his arm. Fap. Wap. 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 Don't turn here. And don't let the arm go. Keep your knee close to his head and your body down. So he has a hard time to twist or to get his arm out. Yeah, the other arm, I mean. Yeah, see? That's a lousy feeling. Now, don't start here. A lot of people are so supple in the shoulders that you can't overstretch the arm. But go to his hip. And now you got him. See? That's all. It. Get your head in. Put your elbow in his ribs. He likes that. Fuck. Get your knee on it. Up. See? Control. Control. Only thing he can do is trying to hit you with the knees. And I always help him then, like hitting him in the balls. Another one, when he is almost out, like this, get your arm in. Hold him here. Here, it won't work. But just turn. And here you got him again. Thank you.
Just.
Right.